Hi, and welcome back to the show. Here I'm, I guess you could say I'm piecing together some more Auto World I've found and trying to add to basically my Auto World collection, which I'll probably eventually be going over. I've only been collecting for a year, and Hot Wheels are alright. Green Light's got some nice stuff. Of course, Tomica Limited Vintage. But I've really gotten into this brand, Auto World. And the struggle is real. I'm really actually trying to find everything that's basically premium. And not so much going after the license premium, but what I can in the premium. And it's pretty difficult. I think out of all the Auto Worlds, usually only puts out like an A or B. Of course, their original releases were they didn't have numbers. Like release 5 has 4 different releases to that same release, like A, B, C, D. The same with 2017 release 1, A, B, C, D. Then I run into a lot of problems a lot of times when you see the cars, they look the same, the color looks the same. Similar, I should say. And then you get into trying to figure it out. And it's taken me a while, actually, to comprehend the various differences in these. For example, there's a license premium. Some of those vehicles are the same color as maybe a year later. You'll find one other vehicle the same color 2 years later. But they're off by the year and minute differences. But something I've noticed across the sets like A and B and C and D, when they're the same car, usually, not always, that's another thing, usually the license plates are the same. So if you run into things like the Cutlass, there's I think like 1, 2, 3. If you're just looking at them on picture or video, the Oldsmobile, that car is black, white interior, red interior, red interior, but the license plates are different. For example, like this, see that white pinstripe? That's really sharp down the side of that. But I really wasn't into this brand per se like I am now. I want to just collect all the premium by set. Was more into the particular vehicles, like particular cars. So I like this car, I like that car. And for example, like the 1969 Kingswood, I thought, well, y'all get all these different color Kingswood. I like that casting, it looks really nice. And some cars I didn't like, for example, this one, the Cyclone, didn't care for it. Now I like it. It's like this brand has really grown on me big time. And now I want to collect at the very best, the premium, as I've stated. But here I have some more that I'm going to add. And I actually, this video is super long. I can't even add, like, what's going on here. But trying to sort it out, I turn around and add the Camaros, 2 Camaros, and the Barracudas that's missing in one of these sets. Trying to figure out what it is, because when I first started collecting Auto World, I did not collect Auto World based on a set per se. I didn't even know where to get it. So like most people, I was looking around online and stuff and plucking it up a car at a time, or Walmart or Target or wherever I could find them just hanging. I just pluck them up. And for only being at it a year, it's a struggle, because some of the older sets are really hard to find. Especially like that Premium 5 set C and D. Took me a long time to encounter the full case. And hopefully that's come through to me. I didn't even know it existed. I have had a hard time figuring out exactly what Auto World makes, because they send you a catalog. But it's that catalog usually pertains to what they have for sale at the moment. and some of the cars are overlagged, and then some of the, how do I explain this, like, you get the 2020 example catalog, and it'll have two, three sets from 2019. It'll have a set that doesn't no longer exist from like 2018 or 17, or set one that you can't order. But it's rather confusing and difficult to explain. But I found a way to kind of sort it out through their Auto World Garage. If you go to www.autoworldgarage.com, you'll see all the way from premium release 1, 2, 3, 4, all the way down. Those do not have years on them, which leads to even more confusion, because people selling the cars, they'll put years on the car, like when it was produced, because they're actually looking at the physical back of it. And I've tried to search to sort things out, but anyway, I'm rambling on. But I got some really nice older vehicles going on here. I'm kind of sorting through everything now as I'm cracking and putting away and trying to put all the sets together, figure out what I'm missing, what I have, what I don't have. And I think now I'm missing one, two, I think like three sets of all of Auto World. And then from 2017 release one, I'm missing one, two, three, four, five cars out of six set of how do I explain that, four cases of six sets. That'd be right, A, B, C, D. Yeah, well, out of the 24, I'm missing 1, 2, 3 four, five cars out of that first release of 2017. And then I'm fighting with that, and you guys know that 2017 release 3, that's another struggle. But so far, I've almost got it all done. And feeling really good, but Auto World just keeps pumping it out, so it's hard to keep up. And then they're putting out all these little exclusives, and it's kind of hard to know. I don't know where to go to see what exclusives they're putting out outside of the what you'd get at a diecast wholesale, like their GT40s that they put out dirty, but like their Golf pickups that I got, some of the things I got is just running searches, and I find these off the wall exclusives. I wish there was a way to know what exclusives they put out, because they don't put this kind of information out on their store or website that I'm aware of. I don't know how to keep up with it. I follow them on Instagram, but they don't really put out a whole lot either. But in any rate, it's pretty nice, cool looking Challenger. Very, very nice. They got a lot of detail going on. Basically, I'm just trying to get the color-coded boxes and everything down so I don't get confused later. That's another way I've determined how to distinguish, since I have some in, I explained this, one here, two there, plucked out of sets and stuff. I've learned that there's also different colors. The cars can be the same color, but if you look at the box, like this one has blue at the bottom, well, another one might be yellow or brown or whatever. It's another way to distinguish, because it does get difficult. I believe they have 155 sets was the claim. I don't know, I'd have to go back and look. That's a lot of sets. I'm not trying to get all those, just the premiums. But so far so good. I think I'm having some luck. Here's that 73 Challenger. Looks nice. Real, real nice. The silver pewter that came in the Hemmings, that license premium one, that's nice. And then I need the opposite to this one. That's another one. believe it's like a reddish orangish color. Some really sharp looking cars that the world produces there though. Looks nice with that white top. Yeah. I was all working and decided to sort through some of my stuff. So I have no clue. I think I'm going to lay off the Hot Wheels for a little while. I know they're putting out the Fast and Furious. That's about all I'm going to do. I got the Dirty Blonde. I need to crack that 55 gasser open. Probably put it up also in a video. But kind of sort of done with Hot Wheels. I'm mostly like Auto World, Tomica, Aoshima, Mini GT. That's kind of it. Hot Wheels car culture is nice, but I might have to lay off of it because I'm really trying to finish off with the Auto World. It's a pretty sharp looking Polara. I remember when I first seen this car, I did not like it. I didn't like this or the Phoenix, Dodge Dart Phoenix. Nah, I like them both. It's crazy. I actually think this car looks pretty cool with that big, crazy front grille. It's a pretty sharp looking ride. I'll give it that. So strange. I started off, I didn't even get a single one of these Grand Prix. I didn't like them. And now, I'm almost getting them all. Almost. Not quite. I think I need... I'm still hung up on those Polaras from that 2017 release one. Man, those are nice. I need to get like three more of those and I'll almost have that set complete. I like the color on this one. It's really sharp. And I'll just move forward. Added on here the new release. Never got around to putting this up in a video, but here we go. As with all things Auto World, this thing looks absolutely spectacular. Fabulous. I like this one. It almost, when I first seen it, I was like, oh man, I got upset. I thought I know people were gonna, they made it this far in the video. What? You got upset? Yeah, I got upset because I thought this was an ultra red at first. And I was like, oh man. I don't really like getting ultra reds, but no, it's the color. It's kind of a, like a metallic root beer looking color. It's kind of hard to explain. I think that's what it's called, root beer red, something like that. I don't know. I just like it. It's really, really nice. And like I was saying, you can get confused. Sometimes Auto World will make vehicles in the same color, but they'll be a year or two off. Sample on this one, the slats on the front grill, there are less slats on the front grill. I'll show you what I'm talking about here in a second. But this thing is really, really nice looking. Done really well. I don't know about the interior matching that out exterior color. It's kind of a bright, but see what I'm saying there? If you look at the blue truck, the grill has more lines. If you look at the root beer red one, it has less lines. But that's kind of sort of the main difference there, the slats on the grill and the ear, between the ears. I think that's common knowledge. I'm not seeing anything out of the ordinary and people wouldn't know. But just in case, try to get the license plate in there. License plates, I'm starting to learn, are pretty important when you have three or four cars that they're the same color, same look. Often the interior could be different or simply what's under the hood. More Camaros. I love the fact that they used the original LE rims on these. These are the same rims they had on that very first release of these square body pickups. I believe that's them. They sure look like it to me. Either way, these Camaros are really nice. I like the, I wish they'd make those Challengers, the newer Challengers, that it's like they only made them in that LE Series 1. Wow, look at that. What's cool about these are the halo lights on them. It's a little bit hard to see them. Probably most of the collectors ain't really paid much attention, but they try to go for the that circular halo look in the middle of the lights. If you hold it just right, you can see. I think it shows out more on the green one. Some really nice detail going on that thing. Very, very sharp. Mouse trying to get the hood open on this, and I'm smacking it so hard the camera is vibrating, and literally I have this thing on a tripod and it just will not come open. And I thought, well, I'll try to pry it open. I said, nah, I'm better not. I'll chip the paint or something and then I'll cry like a little girl. But there it is, sharp looking. Love that. Looks really, really awesome. But you're going to ask me what's it. I don't know. And there's something about Auto World. They stopped putting them on those little... stopped putting them on the cards with the little boxes like I was showing just a few minutes ago. They're just on this cardboard and you just peel them off. It's called a blister. For those of you that do know. For those that don't, it's called a blister because it's just plastic. It's like a plastic encasing glued to the cardboard backing. But they used to give these in like a little box like Matchbox does, so you could stick the car in it, but they stopped doing it. See, now it's just in plastic. Once you rip it open, that's it. They're making higher numbers, which I thought originally would turn me away from Auto World. I don't like that, higher numbers. In fact, I wish nobody collected Auto World but me. That way I could get all the Auto World stuff I'm missing, or the amount of people collecting were less. But either way, it is a really good brand. They really do make highly detailed models. But my fear is, like, in general, like, Greenlight was really good when they had real low mintage on their vehicles. And then they started getting into high mint and the quality went down. And I don't know, I'm afraid the higher up they go, the quality will go down. And I, much as I like Auto World, I don't want to be veered away by that. But so far, so good. These Jeeps are nicely detailed. There's a lot of people that say Greenlight has it better because the tops come off or they have the little roll bar in there. But as far as detail on the outside goes, I disagree. I think Auto World has done really, really well. In fact, they look really, really realistic. Yeah, I've seen the Greenlight. As a matter of fact, I got some at the end of this video that I found on the pegs, and I didn't even bother with them because it seems like they overkill with the black, dark colors. Now, I don't know what to think about this. I don't know how many Buick Estate wagons they need to put in a set of six. I guess it's the casting they got, so they're going to paint it every color they can. But either way, I'm going to collect it because I'm trying to collect all the sets Auto World puts out. But still cool. Still looks good. And these things do not fit in a carny case. They do not fit in the Auto World 6 car case. These things I just had to put on the built display I made because they're just ginormous. The Fords that came in these sets, and now the Chevys, which they're nice looking. This is a Chevy High Country. I believe it's the High Country, yeah. But nonetheless, did pretty good with the detail. I would have rather had, like, older model, but that's just me. 85, 86, 87 Silverado would have been nice. I think they really jumped way up there. But I understand why they did that, because green light is way up there now. And they're doing a lot of old, new, everything. And to be honest with you, Auto World, being the fact that they have access to some castings that they could refine very, very well, could probably put a lot of these competitors down in the dirt if they wanted to. And I'm not just saying that, I know that, but like I said, it's a quality control thing, and they've done really, really well with this Chevy Silverado. I have to hand it to them. It's got the steps on the bumper, the whole nine yards, like the High Country does. I don't really care for it. I'm a Chevy guy, and I don't really care for the new model Chevys. That's just me. They look strange. But anyway, let's get back to a classic. I think we've seen this a million times over. Still, nonetheless, it's nice to have it. And wait, do not care. I'm kind of leaving it there for those of you that can see. You can see the facts and stuff. I left every single card in there so you guys could just pause it and read it if you want. This is a sweet looking ride. I think they've done this car in several different colors, but it doesn't get old. Doesn't get old at all. Yeah. And here we go on to the next one. I kind of like that root beer red one, but to be honest with you, I'm split between the two. This one looks really nice also. And actually, I think this one is my favorite. Of course, it was a lot of people's favorites. That's why I'm not saying it is my favorite, because then I just sound cliche like everybody else. But from the two, yeah, I'd have to give it. This one is one of the better ones. We're back to square one. See right there? It was... I can't even read it. Anyways. I'm not going to slow it down because I'm sitting here looking at everything. This is really nice, man. Really, really nice. Let's move this back. Zoom in on it. Not bad. They plan on doing these on a lift kit. And yeah, you can go online right now and probably scavenge them all over the bay. They're on a lift kit. You got people lifting these up. I don't know. I understand customizing a lot of things. I've seen some of these Auto Worlds customize. I just cringe. Sorry, but I cringe. Guys, if you're customizing these and you're trying to sell them, I cringe when I see it. I'm like, how can you destroy an Auto World? I don't know. Seems like a big no-no to me, but there, nonetheless, it's pretty nice. If you got the talent to do it, why not? But I still cringe. I watched the guy drill him out. It's a big YouTuber. When they first put out the Auto World square bodies, he was drilling them out, trying to compare them to like the M2s. And when he drilled them out, he's like, what? These things are solid on the inside. He was kind of thrown back by it. Put them up on a lift kit and stuff. I still cringed. But his viewers seem pretty excited about it. It's not my thing. This is a pretty sharp looking... I like that. It's a pretty sharp looking Camaro. That green is just eye popping. Trying to think, I've seen one in real life this color, but I just can't remember where, who. Man, they've done really good with these Camaros. I'm fairly impressed. Yeah, Auto World's really something else, and Greenlight too. I got them. Few more cars once I get over this Auto World. A couple cars of Green Light. Two or three of Johnny Lightnings. Not too many more Hot Wheels. Man. They did really good. Of course, I've had several Camaros from their original pump outs. This car, here we go again. If you didn't see this on the blister and you've seen it sitting somewhere, could confuse you. If you pop this off the blister and sat it down, you'd be totally confused as to what it goes to. Nonetheless, try to let y'all read the facts. There it is. See what else we got going on. Boy, she is a beauty. That paint just looks so fresh and so clean. Any rate, super nice looking. Another spectacular automobile by Auto World. Yeah. Check out this Jeep. I'm gonna open up the Jeep to this. It's the difference between these Jeeps. One is pull handle, one is push knob. The two different models, they look the same body wise, but one the handles pull open, the other one has like a little push button where you push the little button in to pull the door open. But either rate, sharp looking, looks good in red, looks good in black, looks good in blue, looks good in silver. Keep them coming, Auto World. I think they did 1, 2, 3. I think they did 4 sets last year. Something like that. And hopefully they do 4 this year. Not. I just hope they don't do that A, B, C, D, E, F, G. I'll cry. Not that I won't get it because I'm here now to get it, but boy, backlogging all this stuff is just, it's been a nightmare for me. I've been to the deepest, darkest realms of the internet looking. Here's that other Silverado. Ooh, yeah. They're saying they're having more of these coming too. They're going to make a few more. I don't know how many more, but they said they're gonna make a few more. Watch them put this on a lift kit. Good God. And I'm telling you, these Silverados and those Fords, my goodness, they're pretty hefty chunk of metal for being 164. Pretty hefty. Yeah. Pretty realistic looking, pretty sharp. Gotta give them credit. That front end, that blue bow tie. Of course, there's gonna be le critiques. Oh, green light this, the pickup's better. Yeah. I disagree. I can tell you these Auto Worlds are pretty solid vehicles. I've dropped a few and not even a scratch on them. Now this I can get behind. It's so weird. Like, I've not been a huge fan of this casting, but it's grown on me because it's a station wagon. And station wagons are rare in the 164 scale. But they've made quite a few of these, and I think it's just too many. In my opinion, though, but this silver looks really nice. It looks good. That red interior just stands right out. It's grown on me, but not grown on me, but still is cool. It's mean looking. Look at that. It is sharp. I don't really care because they do really good on their vehicles. So it's Auto World. So I'm on. Get it? Got it? Look at that. Man. This is mainly for me, for remembrance, documenting, but nonetheless, I'm here, might as well do it. So I'm going to move on now, because I was talking about green light, so I'm going to open a green light, why not? You'll see, I'll leave it at the end. I got a bunch of different hunts at the end. I found a 1957 treasure hunt Chevy Hot Wheels, a green machine station wagon. Boy, this Jeep, just man sharp. Man, is it sharp. I like to see this thing on like a 6-inch lift kit. Johnny Lightning would kill it on a 6-inch lift kit. For those of you that even made it this far and don't know, this Jeep is made by Johnny Lightning. Auto World and Johnny Lightning both are owned by a company called Round 2. And Johnny Lightning for many, many years has been the competition to Hot Wheels. But Johnny Lightning had a struggle, and like with most things, it has to do with scale models or even models or just the competition in general. Round 2 has saved them in the past. They've done that with the model cars when that went out of style. And here I picked up this Hot Wheels for the Fast and the Furious. I think it was one I was missing. But anyway, Beverly Hills Cop, pretty nice. I really, really like this Jeep. This Jeep is sweet. I'm gonna open up this Beverly Hills Cop. This Nova is tight. Kind of surprised me that they did this, but nonetheless, it's cool. I wasn't too sure how I felt about this, because it's dirty, like a dirty version, which means they did some kind of artistic deco or whatever to it to make it look dirty. And actually, it looks pretty good. I was kind of surprised. I, in general, like to stick to cars that, you know, they're normal, but it's movies. So I collect movies, cars for sure. And yes, Beverly Hills Cop was back in my day, whole banana in the tailpipe thing. I don't know how many people actually believe that. I wonder if it even works. I don't even know. I'll probably research that later to see if the whole banana in the tailpipe thing works. But he sticks, some detectives are following him. He's a cop himself. And he sticks a banana in their tailpipe. And it supposedly chokes the car out. Of course, it probably would work because there's exhaust. If there's no escape, then drowns the motor. Actually, I think the banana would just turn to mush from the heat, especially coming out of V8. It's a sweet looking car, though. They did a lot of detail on this thing, a whole lot of detail. I'm actually kind of surprised. It's a lot of detail going on. I don't know how he'd actually see out that window, though, if he was driving that thing, because, man, them windows are dirty. Double dirty. Real, real dirty. Gonna go ahead and move on to this Jeep. Let's see what's going on with this Jeep here. That's a sharp-looking paint job. Very sharp-looking paint job. I like the way the white letters stand out on the tires. This thing looks really, really good. I think Johnny Lightning totally crushed it. Yeah, it does look nice. some awesome detail. That's for sure. It's very realistic. Very, very realistic. Wow. Holy awesome. Sweet looking ride. Yes, sirree. Sweet looking ride. Man. Looks very realistic. It's got a winch on the front of it, huh? That's freaking cool. I actually like this. Johnny Lightning did really, really good with these Jeeps. They do really good with their off-road vehicles. The stance looks correct on it and everything. I'm pretty surprised. I got this off the pegs. It's like I couldn't pass it up. It's a Dodge Viper there too. I was like, looks good, but I think that fin, that tail fin on it looks crazy. Here I am on a hunt, guys. Have you seen that? I found the Prelude hanging there. I was like, I've been looking for that for a little bit there, that Prelude. This is weird looking. Look at this, guys. Bam. 57 Chevy Spectra paint. And there's the gold flame on the bottom. Super treasure hunt. I believe it's just hanging here. It's just a regular store. See that, guys? That is a Green Machine station wagon. This is a black Jeep from Green Light. There's a lot of stuff going on in this video. Vista. Some tires. You want to change out your Green Light wheels. I may start doing some wheel swaps on some of my Green Lights. I do not really like doing things like that, but because I don't know what I'm doing. But I'm probably going to start giving it a shot. Smoking the Bandit station wagon. That's something right there. I don't remember there being a station wagon in that movie. I'm going to have to go back and watch it. May just be a gimmick to pull the trigger. But I don't remember the sheriff having a station wagon. Sweet hobby. Wow. There's quite a bit of stuff going on in here. Yes, sirree. Look at that. That's nice. Coca-Cola M2. Having trouble keeping everything steady. I'm holding stuff here, guys. You know how it is. You go in, you're looking at something, and you just start filling up the arms. Truck and trailer. HRR. Very curious about that HRR. So that's what I'm talking about. Johnny Lightning has a lot of off-the-wall cars. I wouldn't exactly call them off-the-wall, man. That's sweet. I wouldn't call them off-the-wall, per se, but cars that just are unexpected. And I think if they refined some of those, turned them down to the 164 scale and did a whole lot of Overwatch on them, they'd have a serious thing going on. Look at all these Hondas from Hot Wheels. Seems like I have seen these sets like crazy in a lot of different places. People like customizing those up. Look at all of those. Man. Yeah. Let's see what else is going on here. Oh, more Auto World. Auto World. Oh, there it is. See? Jeepo. Buick, hello. Some Matchbox. I have not even gotten around to opening half this stuff, guys. Got all these Hot Wheels. Boulevard. Boulevard. Door jammers. Man, they even got these Hondas over here. All this stuff. Hello. Thunder, 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 thunder. What? Spy who loved me. Man, this thing is just... it's got quite a bit of stuff in it. Just kind of fumbling through, really. Not that interested in Hot Wheels at the moment. I'm looking for older Auto World cars. Sometimes I have really good luck. It's interesting. I'm also looking for another Golf for one of my viewers. It's that Golf GT40 treasure hunt. Still haven't found another one. They asked me for it after I found two and I wound up trading them. But if I find a third one, I'll be shocked. Got down here. Interesting. Nothing really going on. Well, that's the show. Thanks for stopping by, guys. Y'all have a good one, and I'll see you on the next episode.